In this example, we'll be creating an inline function to plot a nonlinear function, which we'll be carrying through later in this series of lectures. But first, we want to create the function that we'll later be using. So first, we're given the definition of the function in terms of t, a, and b. And we want to see how does this function behave for given parameters a and b over a time span negative 2 pi to 2 pi. So the first thing I can do here is I can define this function y. Again, I'm going to use an inline function here. And in this case, we'll have three arguments, t, a, and b, that it takes. The order doesn't matter that I put these in, except that later when I use my function, I will have to use the same order that my first argument is t, my second is a, and my third will be b. So to construct this, I need t plus a. I'm going to be putting in a vector value for t, so right away I know I have to use the dot times, because t plus a is going to be a vector, so I need to dot it with, or dot multiply it with cosine of t plus b, which will also be a vector once I have a value of a vector value for t in. And let me start with clearing out all the old stuff. So in this case, it threw an error. I forgot to put a semicolon after CLC. So now if I run this, I have here my y variable, which is my inline function. All right, so I have it defined. It takes t, it takes a, and it takes b. So now I want to see what does this look like over the interval from t is negative 2 pi to positive 2 pi. So as I've done in the past, I can make a lin space here that goes, starts at negative 2 times pi until 2 times pi. And I'll use 1,000 values in between for this. And here I do have a, I'm going to use 2 for now, and b, I'm going to use 1.1. And the way I can plot this is my independent variable t, my dependent variable is going to be y. Now here I'm going to put the function evaluation itself into my plot. So y of t, which is a vector, a, which is a scalar, b, which is a scalar. And I'll plot this as a green line. Right, so if I run this, I've plotted from negative 2 pi to 2 pi. It doesn't look that great yet, so let me zoom in on the interesting part of this plot and rerun this. All right, so here I have my function plotted from negative 2 pi to 2 pi for these particular parameters. And just as an illustration, what this lets us do by putting it into making a function of t and a and b is I can easily change my values for a and b, rerun this section of code, and we see that the function itself changes because of changing the parameter a in this case. Going back to my original, this is the plot I get, and again, we'll be continuing with this example forward.